Are you lactose intolerant? Probably, most adults are. And in this video, I'm going to be explaining why so many people are lactose intolerant, how to test whether you have lactose intolerance, and three awesome tactics that you can use to live with lactose intolerance and eat anything that you want. G'day there guys, I'm Jesse Crow, the traveling scientist. And after studying years of pharmacology, I'm here to help you live smarter, happier, healthier lives. Now, lactose intolerance. Lactose is a sugar that's found in dairy products like milk, butter, cheese, and all of these things. Lactase is the enzyme in our stomachs that helps us digest these foods. See, when we're babies, we need the lactase enzyme to help us digest our mother's breast milk, which helps us develop in those initial stages of life. By the time we're teenagers and adults, we shouldn't be able to digest lactose anymore because we're not sucking on our mother's breast.
You are such a little cutie.
Mom, I'm trying to eat here. But, Mom.
However, around 15,000 years ago, some guy went up to a cow and started sucking on its teats for milk. Like that's a totally normal thing to do. And I'm almost certain that's exactly how the dairy industry started. I mean, cattle domestication grew from that, and some people were able to maintain the lactase enzyme into adulthood, giving them access to a whole new food group, dairy. And these people are known as lactase persistent, meaning that lactase enzyme did hang around a lot longer than it should have. So don't get me wrong, this is a mutation. It's not natural for us to be able to digest lactose as adults. But it sure is tasty. Lactose intolerant people don't produce enough lactase enzyme to digest dairy, and as a result, any lactose that they ingest passes through their small intestines and goes down into their colon, where it interacts with gut bacteria, producing a lot of byproducts and leading to symptoms like gas, bloating, cramps, and even diarrhea. About 65% of the people in the world will experience lactose intolerance as they grow older. And in certain parts of Asia, it affects up to 90% of the population, while certain parts of Europe, it affects only 5% of the population. But in general, lactose intolerance can be considered the world's most common genetic disorder. Don't quote me on that. Not sure if you're lactose intolerant? Well, there's three tests you can do to find out. First, the hydrogen breath test involves drinking a lactose-based drink and then breathing into a balloon every 15 minutes for 2 hours. And then the doctor is going to check the gas in those balloons looking for hydrogen gas, which would indicate that the bacteria in your colon is digesting that lactose improperly. Another test you can do is the blood sugar test, where a doctor will check your blood glucose levels before and after drinking a lactose-based beverage. If your blood glucose doesn't change, it suggests that the lactose isn't being digested and absorbed into your bloodstream like a normal sugar, so you're lactose intolerant. And finally, a test that you can do at home is to simply cut all lactose out of your diet. No cheese, no milk, no chocolate, no nothing with lactose in it. Try that for a couple of days, and if you start to feel pretty good about yourself, you're probably just lactose intolerant. And if you are lactose intolerant, rejoice in the fact that you are a perfectly normal human. Dairy products aren't a natural source of nutrition, and you can live happily and healthy without them. And if you're a lactase persistent mutant, well then you can rejoice in the fact that you can drink all the chocolate milk and eat all the cheese that you want, you weird mutant bastard. So you're lactose intolerant. Welcome to the club. You're up there with most human beings. And I have three awesome tactics to help you survive and thrive with your condition. Tip number one is to eat less dairy. I know, crazy, right? But the point I'm trying to make is that your body still produces a small amount of lactase, maybe not as much as it used to, but if you try just eating a little bit of cheese or a small amount of chocolate, you can probably find an amount of dairy that works for your body. You shouldn't have to cut dairy out completely. Tip number two is to switch to dairy-free products. It's 2019, people. Everything has a dairy-free alternative. Instead of cow's milk, drink soy milk or almond milk or coconut milk. Instead of regular chocolate, try eating dark chocolate. Instead of regular cheese, try eating vegan cheese. And if you're not sure if it contains lactose or not, just check the ingredients. And tip number three, if you really want to keep eating dairy, like you just need it in your life and you can't let dairy go, Well, there's a pill for that. You can just go down to your local pharmacy or drugstore and buy some lactase tablets. And by taking one of these tablets before consuming dairy, it should prevent or at least reduce the symptoms of lactose intolerance. And just a little fun fact, the lactase that's in those tablets is actually produced on an industrial scale in fungus. Yeah, it comes from mushrooms, which is pretty weird, but kind of cool. So if you're happy taking lactase that comes from mushrooms, then you can eat all the damn lactose that you want. Anyway, that's all for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you learned something, click the like button down below. And which one are you, a normal lactose intolerant human or a weird lactase persisting mutant? Let us know in the comment section down below, and feel free to share this video with anyone you know who might be lactose intolerant, which is most of the population. Finally, make sure you subscribe for more traveling science every single week. Next week's video is going to be all about ketamine. How does ketamine actually work? We'll find out next Science Sunday. Cheers. Milk, cheese, yogurt, and what else is dairy? What is dairy? You weird mutant bastard. Ooh, me? No, I'm not lactose intolerant. Yet.